What is going on, guys? Welcome back, Commentary Free. You know, we've all now seen Foodie's financial responsibilities have came out and are shown for a lot of people. One person actually paid for those records to be retrieved, but we all know she has a pending date at the end of this month to have that settled, and I was waiting for her. You should know, past couple months, I really haven't used a lot of her content, but I did screen cap some things, and I was waiting for her to delete these videos. So this is when she was having a back and forth with Natter. I want you to first listen to her explaining how Natter was asking her for money, and she cites, "Hey, I'm not rich."
I am not rich, okay? Hi, AMC.
So with that context in mind, I wanted to move forward because later she starts to discuss with us exactly how much money she makes per month at the time and, more importantly, what she was spending it on. So I found this extremely interesting for her to divulge.
So he was asking me for money and I was like, I don't really have any. Like, I'm not rich and I'm like a paycheck to paycheck person. So, yeah, I had, like, the antivirus spamming is so annoying. I think at the time I was making, like, maybe $12,000 a month. And after I pay all my bills, my car payments, all my, like, takeout, and, like, Sephora and Pennington's visas, I can't afford to give this guy cigarette money, okay? So I was like, yeah, at the top I cut it off. I can show you, but I showed my income, so I didn't really want to.
So there you have it. No way to sugarcoat it. No way to work around it. That's her video expressing to you what she makes. Also citing she lives check to check. And then now in the predicament she currently is in. So this is obviously funded very much by the VIBs, people watching her content. And I think we've seen there's been quite a significant fall off in people watching either her or the couple's channel. Now, she can sit there and blame that on anything she likes, including the people that are creating content, but ultimately, I think people have had enough of the way she's been treating the platform, and I also think they're tired of seeing her be irresponsible. What will be interesting now is how long she will stay in Canada and when she will travel back to Kuwait. Love to know your thoughts on this. Appreciate you watching it. I will be back as soon as I can with more content.